Today, in that lecture, we will cover vortex motion. Okay. The vortex motion is defined as the vortex motion is defined as a motion in which the whole fluid mass rotates about an axis. Okay, a mass of fluid is rotation about a fixed axis is called vortex, which is see in the diagram. This axis is called vortex axis, and rotation about this axis is called vortex motion. A vortex motion is characterized by a flow pattern where the streamlines are curved. When fluid flows between curved streams, lines, centrifugal forces and are set up, these are counterbalanced by the pressure force acting in the radial directions. Therefore, the vortex flow is of following types, that is the two types: forced vortex flow and free vortex flow. Two types of vortex flow is categorized here. Therefore, first part, that is the forced vortex flow. Okay. Which is seen in the diagram, stationary cylinder filled by a liquid and rotate about its axis, that is the omega, and a rotating cylinder which is see here the fluid is make a curvilinear paths, that is the depressed path, a concavity which is see here. Forced vortex flow is in which the fluid mass is made it to rotate by a means of some external agency, because it applied by the force externally. The external agency is generally the mechanical power which imparts a constant torque, provided a torque on that body. And then such a flow, there is always expenditure of energy, stored energy, and the forced vortex motion is also called flywheel vortex or rotational vortex. Okay, therefore in this type of flow, the fluid mass rotates at a constant angular velocity, that is the we take omega. Angular velocity, that is the omega. Therefore, the tangential velocity of any fluid particles is given by, that is the v is equal to r omega, where r is the radius of fluid particle from the axis of rotation, which is r. This is the radial distance. And angular velocity is how much? That is the V upon R, and which this value is constant value. Okay. For example, forced vortex is rotation of water through the runner of a turbine, rotation of liquid inside the impeller of a centrifugal pump. We all are seen in village areas or for cultivating purpose, for irrigation purpose, we can sump ground water with the help of centrifugal pump, and your houses we see a small tillu pump, that is the type of centrifugal pump. And third one is the rotation of liquid in vertical cylinder, and we see in the figure above, that is the type of forced vortex flow. नेक्स्ट वन वी कम ऑन द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट दैट इज द नेक्स्ट टाइप दैट इज द फ्री वर्टेक्स फ्लो. दिस इज द अनदर टाइप ऑफ द फ्लूइड फ्लो वर्टेक्स फ्लो दैट इज द फ्री वर्टेक्स फ्लो. इन फ्री वर्टेक्स फ्लो इज वन इन विच द फ्लूइड मास रोटेट्स विदाउट एनी एक्सटर्नल इम्प्रेस्ड कॉन्टैक्ट फोर्स. सेल्फ रोटेशन ओके दैट इज द होल फ्लूइड मास रोटेट्स आइदर ड्यू टू फ्लूइड प्रेशर इटसेल्फ आर द ग्रेविटी आर ड्यू टू रोटेशन प्रीवियसली इम्पार्टेड. द फ्री वर्टेक्स मोशन इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड पोटेंशियल वर्टेक्स आर इरोटेशनल वर्टेक्स फ्लो. फॉर एग्जाम्पल अ फ्री वर्टेक्स फ्लो फ्लो फर्स्ट वन इज द फ्लो अराउंड ए सर्कुलर बेंड. सेकेंड वन ए वर्लपूल इन ए रिवर. थर्ड वन इज द फ्लो ऑफ लिक्विड इन ए सेंट्रीफ्यूगल पंप केजिंग आफ्टर इट हैज लिफ्ट द इम्पेलर. देन दिस टाइप्स ऑफ कॉल्ड फ्लूइड फ्लो आर कॉल्ड फ्री वर्टेक्स फ्लो. Fourth type of flow, free vertex flow, that is the flow of water in a turbine casing between, before it enters the guide valve ends. And number last, fifth type is flow of liquid through a hole, oblique outlet provided at the bottom of a shallow vessel, for example, wash basin, bathtub, etc. Therefore, in free vertex, the relation between velocity and radius is obtained by putting the value of external torque equal to V0 or the time rate change of angular momentum, that is the momentum of momentum must be taken as zero. Therefore, let us consider a particle of mass m at a radial distance r from axis of rotation. Having a tangential velocity that is the v, therefore the momentum of momentum is mv into r, mvr, we can say that is the mvr, and the rate of change of momentum we can take the partial derivatives of that moment of momentum, that is the del y del t of the mvr, and but for the free vertex which it is equal to v zero, therefore integrating these terms and mvr is equal to obtain the constant value, and we can say c, therefore v is equal to c upon r, we can write v is equal to c upon r, and therefore the vertex velocity v is inversely proportional to 1 upon r, that is the when the radius the particle distance of the center of the rotation is increases, therefore the velocity of the particle decreases, and when the radius of the particle distance of the radius of the particle which is situated at the rotation condition is reduces or it decreases, therefore the velocity of rotation is increases. Okay, now the equation of motion of vertex flow, how to calculate, how to formulate the types of equation of vertex flow. Okay, therefore we take a elementary part of the body, that is the ODC, and elementary part that is the ABCD of thickness DR, we see in the diagram which is see here, that is the delta R, and the radial distance is R, and makes an angle is delta theta. Okay, delta theta thickness of, and this is the radial distance, and here the pressure, here pressure in below P, and upper part of that element सेकेंडरी पार्ट ऑफ द प्रेशर इज पी प्लस डेल पी अपॉन डेल आर इंटू डी डी आर, दैट इज द थिकनेस वॉल्यूम. ओके, नाउ लेट अस कंसीडर आर इज द रेडियस ऑफ एलिमेंट फ्रॉम ओ, डी आर इज द डेल्टा आर इज द रेडियल थिकनेस ऑफ द एलिमेंट, गिवन एलिमेंट डेल्टा ए इज इक्वल टू एरिया अक्रॉस द क्रॉस सेक्शनल एरिया ऑफ द एलिमेंट एंड डेल्टा थीटा इज इक्वल टू एंगल ऑफ सबटेंडेड बाय द एलिमेंट एट ओ. देयरफोर द वेरियस फोर्सेज एक्टिंग ऑन द एलिमेंट आर मेनी मेनी टाइप्स ऑफ फोर्सेज एक्टेड एट दैट एलिमेंट पार. फर्स्ट वन इज द सेंट्रीफ्यूगल फोर्स एंड सेंट्रीफ्यूगल फोर्स इज हाउ मच, दैट इज द एम वी स्क्वायर बाई आर, दैट इज द काइनेटिक एनर्जी, काइनेटिक एनर्जी टाइप ऑफ काइनेटिक फोर्स एंड दैट इज द वन बाई टू वी स्क्वायर एंड देयर फोर वी कैलकुलेट एंड द सेंट्रीफ्यूगल फोर्स इज हाउ मच, दैट इज द एम वी स्क्वायर बाई आर एक्टिंग अवे फ्रॉम द सेंटर ओ. सेकेंड इज द प्रेशर, प्रेशर फोर्स दैट इज द पी डेल्टा ए ऑन द फेस ए बी, ए बी फेस इज हाउ मच, दैट इज द पी डेल्टा ए एंड प्रेशर फोर्स ऑन द फेस ऑफ सी डी इज हाउ मच, दैट इज द पी प्लस डेल पी अपॉन डेल आर डी आर इन टू एरिया द एलिमेंटल एलिमेंटल एरिया दैट इज द डेल्टा ए. इक्वेटिंग द फोर्सेस इन द रेडियल डायरेक्शन वी गेट that is the p plus del p upon del r into dr delta a minus p delta a and the all this type of pressure force is equal to the mv square by r, that is the centrifugal force which act up forward directions and therefore, but we know that the mass is equal to m is equal to mass density into volume. Therefore, mass density is rho into delta A into del r, delta r that is the volume into density. Therefore, putting these values and we solve all above the terminology and last we get del p upon del r is equal to rho v square by r. In the expression, del p upon del r is called pressure gradients in the direction of radially, that is the radial direction of the pressure. Okay, therefore we know that del p upon del r is positive, therefore pressure increases with the increases of radius r, and in that case the vertical plane, the variation of pressure is given by the hydrostatic law, that is the del p upon del z is equal to minus times rho g. As the pressure is the function of R and Z, therefore total derivatives of P is we can write here del P upon del P is equal to del P upon del R dr plus del P upon del Z dz. Putting the value of del P upon del R and del P upon del Z in that equations, therefore del P is equal to rho V square upon R dr minus rho G dz. This equation represents the variation of pressure of a rotating fluid in any plane. Okay, now next one we develop the equation of forced vertex flow, which you see here, that is the equation of forced vertex flow. We see in the diagram, that is the we take a cylinder and fill water or fluid and rotate the angular velocity omega like that, that is the angular velocity omega, and the radius of any particle taken as r1 distance and second particle is taken at distance r2 and depth is z1 and z2 respectively. Okay, therefore where omega is the constant angular velocity, now putting all values in the above equations, total derivative equations of the vertex flow, dp is equal to rho omega square r square upon r dr minus rho g dz, we develop above, and solve this, dp is equal to rho omega square rdr minus rho g into dz. Therefore, considering 2.1 and 2, we can assume initially, therefore, the integrating the above equations, the integral limit is 1 to 2, point 1 particle 1 to point particle 2. Therefore, integrating the above equations, we can see here, that is the 1 to 2 integral dp is equal to integral of rho omega square rdr, limit of that integral is 1 to 2 minus integral of rho g dz, integral of that part is 1 to 2. And solve this equations and we get the value that is the p2 minus p1 is equal to how much, which is here, we see here rho omega square upon 2 into r2 square minus r1 square minus rho g z2 minus z1 square. Okay, therefore the angular velocity is equal to v is equal to r omega, therefore at point 1 is r1 omega 1 and v2 is equal to r2 omega 2. And putting these values, therefore we can write here p2 minus p1 is equal to rho by 2 v2 square minus v1 square minus rho g z2 minus z1 square. Okay, when here a conditions arises, first one is the when the points 1 and 2 lies on the free surface of the liquid. Therefore, P1 is equal to P2, both are at like atmospheric pressure and which is the equal. Therefore, the equation is written here, Z2 minus Z1 is equal to V2 square minus V1 square upon 2G. When the point 1 lies on the axis of rotation, second part of that questions. When the point 1 lies on the where axis of rotation axis, okay, exists at the rotation of the axis. Therefore, V1 is equal to omega R1 is equal to W into 0, where R1 is tends to 0, because it coincides the axial radial axis of the rotation. Therefore, V1 is equal to 0, and putting the above value, we can write Z2 minus Z1 is equal to V2 square upon 2Z, and we can say that Z2 minus Z1 is equal to Z, therefore Z is equal to V2 square upon 2Z, and we can write in terms of R omega angular velocity, Z is equal to omega square R2 square upon 2Z. Thus, Z varies with the square of R, hence this above equation is parabola, which means that the free surface of the liquid is paraboloid in shape, which is seen in the figure. We can assume initially and we can prove lastly of that equations. Okay, now next is the we come on the example parts of that question, that topic, that is the we can see here. The example is now. Example is prove that in case of force vortex, the rise of liquid level at the ends is equal to the fall of liquid level at the axis of rotation, which is very important, and this proof is asking in your examination. Okay, that is the YF in you see in the diagram, a cylinder, we can take a fill of water and rotate at its own axis by angular velocity is omega, and therefore the radius of that cylinder is R, capital R. and the rise of the water is yr and fall of the water below part of the water is yf. Therefore yr is equal to yf, which is proof in that equations, that questions. Okay, now we come on the solution parts and let us some assumptions, that is the radius of the cylinder is taking as r and OO is equal to initial liquid level, which is see here, this is the initial level of the liquid, and when this the condition is stationary condition of the cylinder. Now let us consider the cylinder is rotates a constant angular velocity, that is the omega we can take, and the liquid will rise the ends and will fall at the center is how much, that is the yr is rise and yf is the fall. Therefore yr is equal to rise of the liquid at the ends, we see here ends from OO, and yf is the fall of liquid at the center from O after rotation, after angular we provide angular velocity omega of that type of container. Therefore the this condition situations is occur. Now initial height of the liquid is how much, that is the h plus yf. H is the depressed part of the and below part of the container in between distance. Therefore the initial height of the liquid is h plus yf. Therefore volume of the cylinder is cross sectional area and height, that is the pi r square into height, is h plus yf. Putting the value, therefore the volume of liquid is equal to how much, volume of liquid is equal to volume of cylinder up to the level mm level minus volume of paraboloid. Okay, therefore volume of cylinder up to the level of mm is pi r square into liquid height up to the level of mm minus 1 by 2 into pi r square into height of paraboloid. We can write here. Therefore solving the these equations and we get here pi r square h plus pi r square by 2 yf plus yr. Therefore equating the equations above equations 1 and 2 we see here, that is the pi r square h plus yf, that is the initial quantity of the water, volume of the water, and this is the after rotation of the quantity of the volume of the water, which is equal, which is not changed, and we can take equal. Therefore we solve the above and we come on that point, that is the which is see here, and equating this, and we can write here, that is the pi r square by 2 yf is equal to pi r square by 2 yr, and we can prove here the fall of liquid at the center is equal to right of the rise of the liquid at the ends, which is equal in the all conditions, that is the yf is equal to yr. We can prove, and this is the very important asking, influently asking in your examination purpose. Now we solve next example asking about winter AMI. This example, in example that is a cylindrical tank of 9.9 meter is diameter and 2 meter is height, open at top, is filled water, top depth of 1.5 meter, it rotated about its vertical axis at n rpm, n round per minute, determine the value of number, that is the rotation n, which will rise water level with the brim. Okay, brim is understand here, brim is here, this is called brim. Okay, Now we solve the example, given example. Radius is 0.45 meter, length 2 meter, and initial height of the water is 1.5 meter. Now rise and fall is, we can take YF and YR, and total is depth is taken as Z. We see here that is the Z, and total radius of the cylinder is 0.9 meter. Therefore, volume of air before rotation is equal to volume of air after rotations. We can write here in the example, there is a pi r square into 2 minus pi r square into 1.5 is equal to 1 by 2 pi r square into z. Both are all are equal, therefore z is equal to 1 meter. That is the yf plus yr is equal to 1 meter, which is calculated. Using the above relation, that is the z is equal to omega square r square upon 2z, where small r is equal to capital R, which is in given question, that is the, we can take small r is equal to capital R, and putting all these values, therefore omega is equal to 1 calculated and obtained 9.843. therefore, how much the we know that the angular velocity omega is equal to 2 pi n upon 60. Therefore, numbers of the rotation, n is equal to, putting the value of angular velocity, and we can calculate the number is, n is 93.99 rpm, that is approximately 94 round per minute of the that cylinder is rotated. Okay, next type of example we come here. Find the maximum speed of an open circular cylinder having 180 millimeter diameter and 1.2 millimeter length and containing water up to the height of 960 millimeter, at which it should be rotated about its vertical axis to that no water spills. Okay, in that questions, given the radius is here, that is the r is equal to 180 upon 2, that is 90 millimeter and 0.9 meter, which convert in meter. And length of the cylinder is already 1.2 meter given, which is given. Initial height of the water is given 0.96 meter. Therefore, maximum speed of rotation, that is the n, let omega is the angular velocity of the cylinder when the water is about to spin. We know rise of liquid at the ends is equal to fall of the liquid at center. But rise of liquid at ends is equal to length of cylinder minus initial height. And we calculate, because it is already given, that is the 0.24 meter. Fall of liquid at center is 0.24 meter, therefore height of parabola is 0.24 plus 0.24, that is the 0.48 meter, because it is equal, and therefore we can say Z is equal to 0.48 meter. Therefore, using that relation, omega is equal to Z is equal to omega square R square upon 2C, and putting the all values in the given relation, therefore omega is equal to 34.09 radian per second. And now we can use the relation, omega is equal to 2 pi n upon 60, and putting the value of omega, therefore numbers is counted, number is calculated, n is equal to 325.5 rpm. That is the number of rotation as the angular velocity 34.09 radian per second is 325.5 round per minute. Okay. Now we solve another type of example. In that example, a 0.2 to 5 meter diameter cylinder is 1.5 meter long and contains water up to the height of 1.05 meter. Estimate the speed at which the cylinder may be rotated about its vertical axis so that the axial depth becomes zero. Okay, radius of the cylinder is 0.1125 meter, which is calculated here. Length of the cylinder L is equal to 1.5 meter. Initial height of the water is 1.05 meter. Therefore, depth of paraboloid is 1.5 meter. And using the relation Z is equal to omega square R square upon 2Z, putting these values, and we calculate omega is equal to 48.22 radian per second. And now use again the relation omega is equal to 2 pi n upon 60. And now therefore the numbers is calculated. Number of rotation n is equal to 460.46 round per minute, which is calculated, and we see here. Now again we come on the small topic, that is the rotation of a liquid is a closed cylindrical vessel. Therefore, how to understand that type of conditions. Three types of container we see here, that is the A, B and C. All three containers are taken as a closed container. Okay, when a cylindrical vessel sealed at a top and filled with some liquid is rotated about its vertical geometrical axis, therefore the shape of paraboloid formed due to rotation of the vessel will be shown as figure. When omega is equal to 0, then we can see the first condition, that is the A condition. Cylinder vessel, when it is stationary, therefore omega is equal to 0, and we see in the container, that is the container is seen like that. And when the second condition, we rotate the cylinder is angular velocity omega 1, therefore the shape of paraboloid formed, that type, second type of the container. Now third container shows that the shape of paraboloid formed when the speed of rotation is omega 2, that is the omega 2 is greater than omega 1, therefore in the case is the following are unknowns, and the radius is of the parabola at the top of the vessel, and second one is the height of the parabola formed corresponding to the angular velocity to omega 2. To solve these two unknown equations are required. Therefore, one equation, first equation is Z is equal to omega square R square upon 2Z. We know already, we can use this relation. And second relation is developed, that is the second equation is formed fact that for closed vessel, volume of air before rotation is equal to volume of air after rotation, which is in equal. Therefore, volume of air before rotation is equal to how much? Volume of closed vessel minus volume of liquid in vessel. Therefore, volume of air after rotation is equal to volume of paraboloid form. Both volume is equal, and this is equal to 1 by 2 pi r square into z. Therefore, in the case of when the container is a closed type container and rotating the angular velocity omega, therefore we use this relation, and we can obtain the angular velocity as well as the rotation of the cylinder. Therefore, we come on the a short example we can take here, which is, see here, a cylindrical vessel closed at top and bottom is 0.24 meter in diameter, 1.44 meter is height, and contains water up to the height of 9.96 meter. Therefore, find first Find the height of parabola if it is rotated at 480 rpm about its vertical axis. Second one, find the speed of rotation of the vessel when the axial depth of the water is zero. Therefore, radius is 0.12 meter, length of the vessel is 1.44 meter, height of the initial height of the water is 0.96 meter. Therefore, we see the diagram is like that. The speed is equal to given, that is the 480 rpm, omega is equal to 2 pi n upon 60. Therefore, angular velocity, number of angular velocity is calculated, and angular velocity is 50.26 radian per second, which is calculated. And when the vessel is rotated, paraboloid is formed, and as shown in figure, radius r is equal to paraboloid at top of the vessel and z is the height of the paraboloid. Therefore, air as the closed vessel, in the condition of closed vessel, the volume of air before rotation is equal to volume of the air after rotation, which is in equal, and therefore pi r square l minus pi r square into 0.96 is equal to 1 by 2 pi r square into z, which is developed in the above equations. And therefore r square z is calculated and obtained as 0.1138. therefore, using the relation, z is equal to omega square r square upon 2z, we get, putting the all values, therefore r is equal to, in terms of z, upon 128.7. therefore, putting this value r square in l meter, meter, therefore the z is calculated, and z it obtained is 1.333 meter. Now, in the given question, that is the second part, if the speed of rotation, number of rotation is calculated, let omega is the angular velocity when axial depth is zero. Therefore, when axial depth is zero, therefore the height of paraboloid at top is equal to r. Using the relation, z is equal to omega square r square upon 2z, we get, putting these values, omega square r square is here, that is the 28.525. therefore, volume of air before rotation is equal to volume of air after rotation, which is in equal. Therefore, pi r square 1.44 minus 0.96 is equal to volume of paraboloid, and which is calculated, and therefore r square is equal to how much? R square is calculated, that is the 0.0096 meter. Therefore, putting this value of r square in above equation, omega square r square is equal to 28.25, which is seen here, and solve this. Therefore, omega is equal to 54.25 radian per second, and now use the relation, omega is equal to 2 pi n upon 60. Therefore, putting the value of omega in that equations, therefore we calculate the number of rotation is 518 rpm, which is calculated, that is the number of rotation of the that type of liquid.